And the heavy rain that hampered rescue efforts in Turramurra are causing problems all over Sydney. There's been flash flooding, traffic is at a crawl for the commute home, and it's shaping up to be a soggy weekend.
If you thought your trip home was bad, just watch the wild weather turn the harbour into a washing machine. A powerful east coast low has been battering Sydney since Monday, and as more rain fell this morning, the coastal capital broke a long-standing record.
The wettest July in 61 years, when we saw 336 millimetres back in 1950.
Over the past 3 days, Cronulla has been drenched by 255 millimetres of rain. The city's received 200 mils, while in the west, Parramatta has been comparatively dry. July's weather has been severe, and there's still a week to go. 3 more areas have been declared natural disaster zones, including Lithgow, after cyclone-force winds cut power to more than 10,000 homes. For now, weekend sport is out too.
Usually these fields are packed with hundreds of children, their parents all across the sidelines. But for tomorrow and for Sunday, as it has been much of the way through July, it's just going to be a playground for a couple of ducks.
Quite frankly, today it's out of the question.
Eric Galloway manages rugby league on the Northern Beaches. His ovals resemble pools.
We're running out to our semi-finals. If there's no more wet weather after this weekend, we'll be fine.
By the look of these bowling greens, it's not just children missing out.
Nah, I'll throw a couple of beers down. I know about a couple of bowls, mate.
But there'll be no stopping the greyhounds at Wentworth Park.
I think each dog's got its own personality. There's going to be some that will throw a tantrum and not want to go around, and there'll be some that'll thoroughly enjoy it.
And if we're lucky, there may be some good news on Sunday.
Early fog patches and then becoming partly cloudy during the day, so finally that sun will be breaking through.
Auckland Kennedy, 10 News.